Hey guys, Daniel Zero. First, I want to say thank you to everybody for all your support. I don't know what to say about all the people who are making donations and offering to send stuff to me to help me out. I'm a little overwhelmed by all of it. I don't know how to respond, or I don't know what to say, so I guess I'll just say thank you and God bless, and until I can think of something better, you know, we'll go with that. But in the meantime, I'm going to keep doing what I'm doing. I'm getting ready for the storm that's coming, and I was looking at what I have here around the home place and the property, and I had an idea, and I want to share it with you guys. Let me show you what I got going on here. Okay. This is my swimming pool filter system. It's the sand system, and it's got the water pump right next to it. And you know, it comes down out of the pool, and it drains in, and it filters, and then it pumps it back in with some pretty good pressure, pumps it back into the pool. And I got to thinking, man, if the crap had hit the fan, and God forbid that the house catches on fire, and I know the water's green in the pool, I haven't cleaned it yet, sorry. I'm out here in the middle of, you know, I'm out here way out here in the country, man, and I would hate that my house burned completely down without me trying to do something about it. So I'm thinking swimming pool fire truck. And I just had this idea yesterday, and I'm just going to show you what I've done, and we'll see if it works. I've never tried it, and we'll try it. We'll see what happens. What I did was I took off, the only thing that I changed about the filter system, I took off this return hose to where it squirts the water back into the pool with the pressure, and I don't have any kind of a reducer or whatever those things are called, so I just stuck the end of a regular old garden hose in there and clamped that pipe clamp down on there, and hopefully we won't lose too much water, and then I just hooked that up to a regular old garden hose. I got my generator out because I was making sure that it works for the next couple of days, just to make sure, you know, that it's going to be, you know, we're going to be able to have power and keep our freezers going until I can get something figured out. But the generator's working fine. There's my generator. I don't know if you guys know anything about generators. I don't know if this is a good one. It seems to do just fine for what I plan on doing with it, as far as just, you know, a lamp or two, or maybe my computer and the freezers over a couple of hours. But I'm thinking that I think it might have enough juice to where it'll power that pump. And if it does, then I should be able to get water to come out of the end of that hose to maybe put out a fire if there is one in the house. Will I be able to save the whole house? Probably not. But if I could save just a couple of rooms on one end of the house or something, where we still have a roof over our head while we're starting to rebuild, you know, that's what I would be concerned about. I mean, if a fire breaks out, it's a trailer. They take all of about 17 seconds to burn completely down. So if I could save just one room, just this back room here, that would give us a roof to where we could start rebuilding and reworking on the rest of the house. I mean, we're talking extreme emergency SHTF situation here, guys. I would not recommend trying to do this at, you know, at any other situation other than, you know, extreme emergency SHTF, when you don't have anybody to depend on but yourself. That's what we prep for. This is another experiment that we're going to try. So give me 1 second to get the generator going here, and we'll see if this is going to work out or not. So give me 1 second. water pump again. Prime that water pump. Let me show you the problem that I'm having. It's working. I just can't see that there. I need to get a reducer. But if I can squeeze that off enough, it comes out at the end of that hose with some decent pressure on it. So I just got to do a little bit of tweaking. It will work in theory. The questions that I had that are answered, oh my God, is will it shoot water out? Will my generator run the pump? And can I get water into the pump and use it? So yes to all those. I just need to tweak it a little bit, get a reducer, a better fit for that garden hose. And I think we have ourselves an, hang on a minute, let me turn this thing. There. I think it works in theory. The problem, like I said, the problem that's happened is I can't get the water to go through there correctly. Once I can get some sort of reducer made and put it on there, the generator runs a pump, I think we have ourselves an SHTF fire truck. So, if you've got any suggestions, let me know. I'm going to, what I had to end up doing too was the hose that I ran in through the vacuum hose, I just tied a rock on the end of the rope. Tied a rock on the end of the old hose down there to keep it under the water. So, alright guys, for now, like I say, thanks again for all the help. Thanks again for all your support. I'll just keep doing what I do out here and put it on the Lord's hand. So, the end.